Hello everyone. Now we are going to solve the second problem in the differentiation. Now the sum is cos sin x. Here both are differentiable functions, so we have to use the chain rule. First we will take y equal to cos sin x. Now we will differentiate dy by dx equal to differentiation of cos sin x divided by dx. Now we will differentiate the cos x. We know already the formula cos x is nothing but minus sin x. But here we have x, that's why we are writing here x here. But in this case, we have sin x inside. So, while writing, we will write minus sin. Instead of x, we will write sin x. Remember, when we have x, we will write x here. Cos x equal to minus sin x. Differentiation of cos x equal to minus sin x. But in this case, x is not there. Instead, we have a sin x. So, instead of writing x, we will write the sin x. Now, the differentiation of cos x is completed. We can't stop here because sin also a differentiable function. So, we have to go to the chain rule. So, now we have to differentiate sin x with respect to dx. So, this is called the chain rule. This already we differentiated, we write minus sin x into this we have to differentiate now. This is simply a sin x. So we know already the sin x differentiation formula is nothing but cos x. So here also x is there, even here also x is there. So simply we can write it cos x. You may ask the question, x also a differentiable function, whether we need to differentiate. If we differentiate again the x, we will get dx by dx. X with respect to x, both will get cancelled, will get 1. That's why usually we will not differentiate when the x comes. If at all you want to do it, you can do. Okay, it will get cancelled, we will get 1 only. So, the final answer will be minus sin x into cos x. Otherwise, we can write dy by dx, bring cos x in the front, minus cos x into sin x. Is that answer?